situation, you know, like things will get really loud or get really silly, or like the room, the atmosphere will change and we'll get too high energy. Like all these little things, sometimes you have to like foresee them and redirect children in different areas. And sometimes too, like us as adults, maybe it's like Thursday, I'm tired, I'm not feeling well. Children are not really listening. Sometimes they don't really want to deal with that. So I'm trying to find, you know, ways to like help myself in those moments, how to be better, you know, and like try to make it so it doesn't get crazy to that level. Because the center that I work at, this new place, there's 25 children. And so it's the most I've ever had to work with at one time. Like I've done it kind of as a casual before, like kind of going here and there, but not as like I'm the one of the main teachers and I'm like more responsible for it, more responsible for things that happen. So sometimes it's a little bit stressful and challenging. So there's 25 children and 3 teachers. So ages are from 3 to 5, but because we're a brand new center, most of the children are 3. So there's over half of them are 3, and like young 3-year-olds, kind of still like toddlers a little bit, and then some 4-year-olds. So balancing out activities and trying to find the right mix, like balancing it, is a little bit tricky because they're both those age groups are developmentally at different stages and they need different things. Like the 3-year-olds, they sleep and they nap, but most of the 4-year-olds don't. So when the little children, when we are trying to help the little children go to sleep, it's hard to figure out, okay, what do we let the older children do? What can they do that's quiet? Because often they're too loud. There's only so many times you can tell them, like, hey, the other children are sleeping, we need to have quieter voices. It's called being respectful or being nice to the other children because they would like to sleep. So we will play, but we will play quietly. And it's hard for them to understand that, you know. Sometimes some of the 3-year-olds, like, they're so tired and they need to sleep, but they're so stubborn and it's very hard to make them go to sleep. Even if I'm using my ASMR tactics, some of them just doesn't work on them. Like, I know there's one little girl, she likes it if you hold her head and kind of like hold the side of her, like her bum, the side of her butt area, and you kind of shake her like this. But it kind of takes like 10, sometimes 15 minutes. So sometimes I'm so tired of doing that, like I don't want to, but I know it's the only way she's going to sleep. And there's another little girl, she's also so stubborn. You have to be so firm with her. If you ask her, like, sit on your bed or lay on your bed, she's always like, no, no, no. She wants to play with her shoes or her blanket or her stuffy. So sometimes I feel bad because I'm actually like, lay down on your bed, on your bed, on your bed. She's like, no, no, but she kind of starts to do it. And then she'll lay down and she doesn't like to be touched. So it took a very long time, I guess, for her to trust us as teachers to let us touch her to help her sleep. So she's kind of finally there.